talked about the importance of Sanskrit in Ayurveda. We talked about the current state of Ayurveda in Indian universities. We talked about the tribal Vaidyas. Yeah. Now, let's just have a glance in the different shades, in different types, in different natures of Ayurveda across India. Because in the West, we think, oh, Ayurveda is from India, and if I go to India, I'll learn Ayurveda. It doesn't matter if I'm going to Varanasi or if I'm going to Trivandrum. It's just the same. In the concept of a person from that is away from the background of India, that there are several types of, I wouldn't say schools, but traditions of Ayurveda that are brought forth in that language, because we are doing Panchakarma, and the doctor said, oh, this is just in Malayalam, the book. It's from a traditional Ayurveda that we only have in Malayalam, it's not written in English. So, just for us to close this this conversation, can you tell a little bit about the amount of Ayurveda that you think in Kerala, it's available only in Malayalam, that is not in Sanskrit, or in Tamil Nadu, what do you expect? Because I believe that around half of the Ayurveda that is currently being practiced in Kerala is Keralaya Ayurveda, is not Ayurveda of Charaka and so on. So, the states, they develop a lot of information that is that only available in their native language.
That is actually how that Keralaya Ayurveda or the regional importance was given for the Ayurveda is because, see, we are taking the herbs from the nature. And the climatical conditions are very important to prepare the aushadhas. So how you will prepare the rasaushadhi in Kerala, it is very difficult because always there will be moisture. Rasaushadhi, preparation of rasaushadhi, read the dry nature, very much dry atmosphere, then only rasaushadhi can be made.
Rasaushadhi, you're mercury, saying about mercury.
Mercury, with the mercury.
Yes.
So, the places where it can be purified, they will be using more mercury-oriented treatment in those places,
this
and less herbal they will be using. But Kerala is a place where the herbal plants are plenty. Now it is exhausting, getting exhausted because of the continuous use and the lack of forests and etc. Climatical conditions also are changing. But still, in Kerala, the herbal plants are plenty. And Charaka, Susruta, Vagbhada, they all traveled all over India. They studied all the plants all over India because they know the geography of India. So, they enlisted almost important plants from all over India. So, these textbooks are basic textbooks to prepare the basic theory of Ayurveda. But when you come to Kerala, there are some plants which are available only in Kerala. There are some system that which the climatical system that which is only in Kerala. So, they developed, they took that all basic principles and they developed a system using their herbs, adjusting to their climatical conditions and following a treatment methodology. That is why it has got the name Keralaya. Yeah. And there are so many regional textbooks speaking about the herbs available in Kerala, which are not found in Samhitas.
Yes, there's so many books. My impression, you can say what is your impression, please. My impression is that like half of what people use nowadays in Kerala is from regional background. In the sense that it's only Malayalam, or if you go to Tamil Nadu, it is going to be... We have this idea that Ayurveda is written in Sanskrit, of course it is, but it's not only written in Sanskrit. So if you go to Maharashtra, if you go to other states, there are going to be a lot of literature there that is not even in Sanskrit.
Yeah.
It's going to be Hindi or whatever.
See, this is what is I told you from the beginning. When the Ayurvedic science was standardized, they brought Charaka Samhita, Susruta Samhita, Ashravakbhada's books, etc. Are, there are Brihatrayi and Laghutrayi.
This was they in standardized, the 70s or 60s? Eh? This was in the 70s, this process?
Books were written very early.
No, say, but the process of standardization
that
was
means,
in 70s?
Maybe because of the university education. Yes. Once again, maybe because of the university education. But they are all the theories consolidated from the regional textbooks which are practiced from by the people of that time. They were not writing anything, they will be simply practicing. From them, they have taken all the theories and they made it into a book. Then the Samhitas came to existence. Otherwise, even if you take Charaka Samhita, it is not written by Charaka Samhita, it is re-edited by Charaka. And it is written by Agnivesha. Agnivesha was one of the student of Atreya. Atreya was teaching, he was continuously asking questions and he just wrote it and it came as a Samhita. So this was the practice of writing Samhitas in olden days. It is not that there is a textbook, one person is writing and making, not present writing textbooks or present publication of research publication, etc. This is not like that. This big group will be discussing, out of that it will be noted. Like that, so many people who does not have knowledge in Sanskrit but used in regional languages has practiced Ayurveda in a great extent. There is no doubt.
So use the word summary in English for Samhita. In the sense that
correct. Brought together that which are spreaded everywhere in different languages and different sect of people brought into it.
In a concise manner. No doubt.
So that is why regional may have something different from the Samhita, because that is not included in the Samhita, which are only for that regional area. So such a way you can regionalize Ayurveda, but you should never say that Charaka Samhita is only textbook, from that you will get everything, nothing like that. But Charaka Samhita is a standardized textbook by the great scholars who has roamed all over India and studied all the culture and made the book. This is very important, you see. Everywhere it is like that. If you take Kalidasa, why Kalidasa is great? Because he knows the culture of whole India. So he whichever be the textbook he write, it will be having influence from regions. It does not mean that everything is created by Kalidasa. He has taken from others. Such a way only Ayurveda also developed. So if you want Ayurveda, you must learn Charaka Samhita. It is for the higher level of learning. If you want Ayurveda as a science of looking after health, even you can learn it from a tribal teacher.